Greetings and hallucinations, ladies and lads. I am Chancellor of the Harmonious Frequencies of the Mighty Empire of Onion, and this is Astroneer. So last time we ran the truck around, we got a bunch of research, we got a few supplies here so that we can expand our base. We were also able to research and craft the winch, which is really cool. I do very much like the winch. It's a really fun tool. If you also remember, over there by where the beacon is, we found a big solar panel. This is what we need to bring that thing back, hook it up to our base, and we can get huge amounts of powers during the day stored up in our batteries. So we have a little bit of resin on our truck, we have a little resin on the backpack. We're wanting to expand the base a little bit. This tree just happens to be in our way. Okay. There has been an update that I'm not really familiar with. I didn't read the change log or anything. It looks like my tool was bugged out for a second. For some reason it was on add terrain instead of digging. Okay. So out this direction, we'll bring one. Put down a resin. It looks like we skipped a middle one there, so just for the sake of symmetry, I'm gonna go ahead and do just about the same. We'll bring it out one more. And then we'll bring it over this direction. Try not to get stuck in there. There we go. Okay, so what don't we have right now? The trade platform is one. It requires aluminum. And the fuel condenser requires copper. That looks like that's the only two things that we don't have yet. Have a little bit of compound here. Let's check over by the smelter. And we have plenty of metal, so we'll be able to make both of those. Yeah, we'll grab those. And we'll need a little bit of resin from the truck. Actually, we might not have enough. No, we don't have enough resin to finish it off. We'll just grab one so that we can get the pod run out this direction. Kind of set us up the base. There we go. So we know we just need, one more resin because we have one on the truck to get that finished off. Let me see what else I wanted to do as well. I want to build some more storage. So let's get that going. And that's all we have enough for right now. We're gonna put this on the truck for sure. There we go. Alright. So now we've got a little bit more space on the truck there. Do we want the trade platform first, or do we want the fuel condenser first? Let's see. This over here is going to be where our spaceship vehicle bay is. Kind of like the way the smelter is over on that side. It's just going to poke out this way. It'll be right there. It'll give us a clear takeoff and landing point for us later. So of course we do need a fuel condenser for our spaceship. The trade platform isn't super useful at this stage. Because there isn't anything really that I need. I should be able to find everything on this planet that I need in order to build ships and take off and all that kind of stuff. So I think I will build the fuel condenser first. Believe it or not, I never built one of these before. There we go. Requires quite a bit of power, it looks like. Which is fine, we have some. That's good incentive also to run out with our truck and grab that solar panel. Okay, but before we do that, I want a little bit more storage for the truck. We are going to need to find more research so that we can research the spaceship. Once we get the spaceship, we'll need aluminum in order to build it, I believe. Alright. Oh, we're out of power, though. That's fine. I'll just throw these compound down here. I keep one on us because looks like we're pretty low on tethers. Okay, good. It only condenses power and makes fuel if I tell it to, and then it will take more power. So we'll just leave it full like it is now for right now. Is that more copper? It sure is. Let's put these over here. There we go. And I'll put the aluminum back for now because clearly we need to wait on that a little bit. We only needed one more, I think it was, resin. So if we find some resin out there, we'll grab that too. Alright. Now if the back of our truck tries to connect over there, yeah, our winch is going to fall off. One solution to that would be to put it up here. To me, that just kind of looks funny. Doesn't quite work out. And I don't know how it's going to affect the vehicle while we're trying to drive. Let me zoom out a little bit here. Alright. Here it is. It looks like it's still loose. Back up to it a little bit. There we go. Okay, then I'll just click on the arrow here. Click on there, and we should be hooked up okay. So let's try to take off. Alright, there we go. So it can't swoosh me. It can't really break my base or anything like that. So we could just haul it along like this. Oh, came unattached. Unattached? Detached? Unattached? There we go. Alright, hang on there, buddy. Oh! I think what happens is my truck's trying to connect to that node every now and then. We might have a better time if we try to drag it from the other end. So I can, as you can see, I can pull this around by just holding the winch. That totally works. Let's attach it up there. I said earlier that that would work best, and I think I'm just going to have to go ahead and go with that. Let's see, there's the base this direction. Okay. So question number one is, where do we want it to be attached? I think this node that's poking out this way right here is just about perfect. If we could get it to flip over, that would be great. Okay. Whoop, whoop. Just try and pick it up here. Woohoo! There we go. Fall back this direction, please. Perfect. Okay. Just dropped it there for now. Let me try and get the truck out of the way. There we go. Now, I don't know if the node will try to connect to the base. If that's not a possibility, then I can build a rover and park it in between these two things, and then it will connect. So where is the sun at? It's over there, and is it setting right now? I believe it is. So that means it probably comes up from that direction and sets back there. So ideally, where it is right now isn't too bad. It won't be getting power in the morning. If I click on that, it releases it. And I feel like this needs to be facing this direction, though. I'm not sure if that's the case. Let me see if we build a rover, if we can get it to connect the way that it is right now. For a rover, we just need 4 compound. We've got that over here. Set up for the storage already. There we go. Ta-da! Rover. And we can use the seat off of our truck because we made it in the printer. There we go. Oh! I didn't wait long enough for it to charge up with power. Huge mistake. Here. We'll just take the battery. Yep, come with me. And drop it on there, should do. That should be plenty of power to get us around here. Okay, so as you can see, the rover's pretty cool. It's just a little cute version of the truck. We got a sandstorm coming in, so I'll probably wait this out before I get out and try to figure out how to connect these. Might do a little perfectionist maneuvering while this is blowing over. Now, one thing that we can do is terraform the ground to kind of shape the direction that this is facing. I hope it doesn't blow away in the storm. I think it's stuck on a tree right now or something. But yeah, if we're close up here, then I can take the winch and kind of maneuver this until it connects to the back here. And that'll be the way that I end up picking it up. I might have to slightly bury the truck and the solar panel to get it to work. And so that it doesn't blow away in the wind, as you can see it's trying to do right now. Ooh! This is a pretty good one. We must be sitting right in the middle of it, just about. Oh, it's flipped it over. That's okay, though. Alright, it's over now. We'll get it hooked up right here. We'll put the battery back where it goes. Grab the winch. Okay, it did flip it over, but that's alright. We can get it back. Attach it over on that side and kind of try to pull it over. We're attached. That should be sending power to anything that needs it on the base. I'm going to see if I can fiddle with it just a little bit. Get this end to drop down some. And what I really wanted to do is just, sit there kind of stationary, more or less. Oh, put that away before I hurt something. There we go. Okay, I think that's in a pretty good shape. We can move it another time if we need to. I'm surprised this wind turbine isn't turning right now, but that's fine. Okay, so we do need to get some more compounds so we can make some more storage for some of these other points here. The fuel condenser, for one, for sure. This vehicle bay could use some, I guess. And whenever we get the trade platform going, I definitely want some for that as well. It looks like we're doing pretty good for right now. I already forgot to switch this over. There we go. We'll get that set up. So I'm going to grab some compound right quick from our renewable nodes, if I can remember where they're at. one entrance into that cavern right there. It's very interesting. Oh, here's a research sitting right here that we haven't checked out yet. Very interesting. Let's grab this up, put that on the truck. I almost said the ship, I was looking at this. Alright, we just left the organic and the seat in here, and that's fine. Let's grab up this compound that's right here, already halfway dug out. Pop. Give it to me, please. Oh. Alright, there we go. I remember we tried to press that little teeny tiny bridge. We weren't very successful with that. So maybe what we'll do is expand that bridge. That's simple enough, right? We're an Astroneer, we can terraform. Perfect. So it feels like the leveling out tool has definitely gotten some work on it. I know that there was an update that was released recently, and it has dynamite in it, and they reworked that tool and a few various other things. Does that look like research to you guys, hanging out inside this rock here? Because it looks like research to me. But I can't... It doesn't look like I'm able to dig the rock. Can we grab it? There we go. Had to hit just the right spot. So that's definitely one we haven't seen before. Worth checking out to be sure. We've still got our winch on the back of the truck too. That's good. Okay. So there's our house back there. This beacon is over here. And like I say, I can't really remember what this is marking. There's a big cave right there. There's a cool rock formation. I do remember that. Looks like there's another crashed ship. But is there research available there, or did I just leave some excessive resources? Either way, we can throw them on the truck and bring them back. It looks like titanium is all that's in there. There's some organic material, but that's not really anything of importance. There's that thing, I don't think it's valuable in any way. So I think what we do is pick this up. Oh, my backpack is full. So I think what we do is empty out my backpack a little bit. Pick this up, pick these up, and then we will get into the truck so that we're safe. And surprise, surprise, our wind generator is working really good in this storm while we were sitting back there. I'm pretty sure this is the general direction towards home, so we'll kind of head this way a little bit. Trying to watch out for big caverns that look like one right there. There's a tree. I saw some other mountains in the distance, and I'm kind of interested to see if they've got more of these research types attached to them. Because I think this might be the one we got ours from. I think our truck says it's worth check it out. Okay, you're really it's really particular where it wants to be picked up at. Whoa, okay. Oh, there we go. Kind of up above it. Wow, I wish it wouldn't spin around like that. Okay, we can attach this to the front of the truck for sure. And does it look just like this other research? It looks a lot like that other research. So I have a feeling that's just going to be a resource. Come on, buddy. Okay, let's see what this has got for us. Yep, hydrazine. Which is fine. We'll stick that on the habitat there. Alright, so this for sure is going to be something new. Because we haven't ever seen this type of research before. Yeah! Give me a spaceship, please! Drill head, that's fine. I think we already have the crane researched. There we go. We'll attach that and it can generate a little bit of electricity. It looks like the rover fell in. I'm not exactly sure how that would have happened, but it did. So let's see if we can fix this. I don't know if the that last storm blew it in to the hole or something. I'm not sure. But it should stay connected right there for the time being. Hopefully with this attached to the tree there, maybe it will hold it still during the next storm. Maybe, maybe not. And the wind turbine just barely turning right there. That's fine. The winch fell off while we were over here. So I'm going to pick that up. Make sure that it's visible somewhere. I forget I can't jump while I'm holding it. On the back, please. There we are. Okay, all set. So we could take some of this resin here. If we get rid of some of our organic. Maybe this will freak out the tree and it'll go away. Nope. Just sitting there turning a little bit. That's fine. So we are going to build the trade platform here first. Woohoo! We are so strong. Okay, got that out of the way now. There we go. So we got the trade platform. Bing! We can trade some things off now. Let's see if we can get anything for a bunch of organic, because we have plenty of that. We don't really need it for anything. See, for 4 organic we can get 2 compound. Zero titanium or coal or lithium or copper, 1 malachite, 1 laterite, 1 hydrazine. For 4 organic we can get 2 organic, 2 resin or 2 compound. Let's hang out for a minute. Okay, so on the printer over there, I want to take this storage and replace it right here. There we go. So we could make some more storage there. Oh, it popped off. Alright, get that research done. Oh, it was only titanium? Well, that's okay. We need that for sure. Let's put that over here. Okay, the storage I'll put on this fuel condenser. There we are. I feel like we are getting power from over there, but let's see what the test will be when we use up all of this stuff right here. See how quickly that replenishes. So we've still got a little bit of sunlight here. Wow, I didn't realize that took such a long time. And it produces one hydrazine here. It doesn't automatically pop it off, which is a little concerning. I would rather that it did. Yeah, so we are getting power all the way from this solar panel back here, which is good. Yep, that resin I'll put up there. Okay, so I want to build another rover. Inside here. So let's just drop that on there. Are we going to need some more compound? We are. I've only got one on me right now. So we do need two compound. Let's just come over here and trade off our organic for it. Let me see if I can select the button. I had to be close enough. I can select these two buttons, but I'm having a hard time getting this one to highlight for some reason. Very strange. Okay, so I'm not sure if that's just some kind of bug or what's going on here. It seems like these are really difficult to highlight as well. Maybe if we can switch that over. Okay, we've got two compounds selected. Yeah, it's just really not wanting me to send off the trade ship. Let's see if we move these, if that makes any sort of a difference. No. Huh. It's almost like the research inside those rocks. It's just got a really particular spot for me to click on or something. But it doesn't seem to be wanting to go. Oh well. Yeah. I'll run out and grab some more compound then. Alright, so we got the compound back. We're going to build a rover here. Just a little guy. I'll run over to the printer as well. And what we want to do here is look for a drill head. Alright, so on our backpack we have one titanium. I'm going to drop that on there. And I know that we need another titanium. I was thinking we had one, but we may not. If we don't, that's fine. We'll likely do this next time. Yeah. Which is okay. Drill head, anyways, is what I mean. We can build the crane. We have the copper. So I'll grab that right quick. Wait a second. The drill head only takes copper? I thought it took titanium, for sure. Huh. Well, that's good to know. Okay. Well, since that is the case, I'll run grab some copper right quick, and we can go ahead and build this bad boy right now. Alright, so I came back with some research. Just gonna open that up. I'm sure it's just gonna be resources, stuff that we already have. You might notice I have two winches now. I actually went down into a cave to get this copper here, and when I got down there, I went down to the very bottom of this very long sort of area, and yeah, at the end of the tunnel there was a winch waiting. So that was pretty neat. We'll take two of these, we'll head over here to the printer, and we'll get these. This silly drill head made of copper. Alright. We've got that going for us. We got the storage up on there. The wind turbine's helping to charge the thing, and we'll put this drill head, bam, right on the crane. Cool, so you might wonder what in the heck do we do with this? Well, we can get in it, we can move around here, and when we find certain rocks and stuff, we can drill. Drill! As far as I know, it'll damage our base platforms here too, so we could dig up part of the base if we really wanted to. And you might say, well, there's simply no room for a chair to drive around. Like, I don't think it'll plop onto the side here, no? So what do we do? Well, I'm going to hop into my little truck right here. I'm going to drive over this direction. And hop out of my truck right there. And I'm going to hook them together. So now wherever this truck goes, it will pull the crane along behind me. And, yeah, I can just hop onto the crane, drill around, and then hop off. So you might wonder what use this is. Well, those rocks that have the research in them, I could drill those away and then access the research a whole lot easier. So there's that. On other planets, whenever you're trying to mine lithium and, titanium, both of those have these undiggable platforms that you have to use the drill to get through. There isn't anything on this planet that I absolutely need this thing for, but I still think it's fun to have. I've never built one before until now, so this is my first time to do that. Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you want to make sure and catch the next one, feel free to subscribe. For as little as $1 a month, you could support my efforts here for bringing content to y'all. And you can check out some of my other videos if you're interested in those as well. Alright. I thank you very much for any and all time that you spent on my channel, and I hope blessings of wisdom and peace on all of you. Farewell.